away from tip-off now. It is the ABL Finals. So if you are spectating, please do grab yourself a seat. Bleachers are behind you. Feel out where you like, make yourself feel comfortable. And also, just to be known, there is a canteen towards the back of the hall there at the top. A university exhibition. So if you haven't decided what you're going to do for your higher education, why don't you go and have a look up there? There's a whole load of information provided from different universities. Go and have a look, see what they can offer. Just to name a few, we've got the University of Essex, University of East Anglia, Birmingham City University, and many more. Make sure you go there before you leave today. Once again, it is the Academy League Finals 2019, and we are 15 minutes away from tip-off.
Thank you. coach then get your ass back. Man, there's no one. What's the point? Yeah, man. Just J?
Jay, Akar J.
Ah.
So just kill, just keep them away.
There isn't a mute. I can't mute them.
Okay.
Fourth, we have Seventh, we have Solis. Eighth, we have Jacobs. Ninth, we have Delmila. Tenth, we have Small. And 11th, we have Pow. So that is the team representing St.Charles College. Okay. They will be playing today. Haringey 6-4. Wow. Representing Haringey today. First we have Young.
Good afternoon and welcome to the Essex Arena here at the University of Essex for the first of three Academy League finals today, starting with the Academy Basketball League before later action with the women's EABL and the men's EABL finals. The first final that we've got up for you today, Haringey Sixth Form College versus St. Charles. My name is Liam Jefferson. I'm joined by Loughborough University head coach Mark Jarram as we're going to be calling today's game. Haringey enter this year's final after an incredible nail-biting victory over Stoke-on-Trent College last week. They were stunned by a last-second three-point shot from Leslie Smith in what might have been one of the most exciting plays of the 2018-19 season thus far. St. Charles, they come into this championship game after defeating Aston Manor Academy in another nail-biter that saw them clinch victory 75-74 in the final four round. Both sides trading baskets early on until first-team all-conference selection Adeido and teammate Tariq Powell punished Aston Manor for some sloppy play on the offensive end to take back the lead and the eventual victory. So we have some exciting basketball action due for you today. Mark, this is our third time calling these finals. What are you most looking forward to across the whole day today?
Well, every single year, guys really showcase some incredible talent. We've had some tremendous finals in the past, and you know, today is going to be no different. There's three finals with a lot of players that will be playing their hearts out. Everything is on the line, everything they've been working for all season long, and it all comes down to this. Now, in terms of this first game, Liam, there's a lot of young players out there, a lot of guys that will be graduating in 2020. So maybe a little bit of nerves from the get-go, but I expect two teams that play a very similar style of basketball. It's going to be fast-paced. Teams are going to be looking for turnovers and easy scores in transition, and it's who's going to be more relentless in this one. But there is some exciting players out there, and I'm excited to watch.
Franklin Agoo being one of those players that I think we're most excited to watch coming into the game, having won the Most Valuable Player Award in the East, averaging 28.5 points per game across the season. But let's not throw out the fact that today pitches up two of the Coach of the Year recipients and winners in Frank Matimba for Haringey and Patrick Avorkila for St. Charles. So interesting to see how those two also match up in the coaching battle, because both teams, I think, coming into this, you can't really decide who's going to come out of it. Everyone that we've spoke to this morning and in the build-up to today's game has said how they just can't call either way which one of these teams is going to take it. So it'll be really interesting to see how this one pans out in our first action at the Essex Arena here at the University of Essex. Just before we get into tip-off, we want to thank our sponsors for today. Obviously, Basketball England as the event delivery, but also Sport England, Wilson, Dynamic, SportServe, FIBA and AOC Sport for all of their support across this season and in the build-up to today's finals.
So Haringey have a 16-0 record in the league, and they're also obviously unbeaten in the knockout stages here. So trying to keep an unbeaten season alive, which is an incredible feat for these young men.
Definitely is. Both teams take the floor and go through the customary pre-game handshakes before battle commences between Haringey and St. Charles. Starters for Haringey, we have Vella, Smith, Morris, Agoo and Newbury. And then at the other end for St. Charles, in the black, we have Mohamed, Akinbaye, Adedo, Small and Powell. The referee's just conferring before we get the game underway.
Gotta love a final, huh? You feel the tension in the room, it's awesome.
And we are underway as Haringey take the first tip and get the first offense straight into the middle of the paint and banks it. Oh.
No nerves from that young man, straight to the basket.
Franklin Agoo, we talked about him pre-game. As there's an answer at the other end for St. Charles.
Well, throw it all out the window. There's no nerves. These guys are ready to battle.
So Agoo now on the perimeter for Haringey, drives inside, no good, looking for the pass to his teammate Newbury. That one goes out of bounds, so it'll be St. Charles possession. And an early sub as well. As maybe that's a matchup situation. Haringey, Cameron Morris checking out of the game. And coming into the game, Alex Distress. Adedo, no good on the free, rebounded by Powell. Another free goes up, no good. And both teams fighting for the offensive rebound as Adedo has his hands all over the game so far, keeps the ball in St. Charles' possession.
Well, he's obviously looking like a guy we keep an eye on in terms of his rebounding numbers, really trying to get after the glass there early in the game.
A baseline possession for St. Charles, struggling to get it in so far, just beats the referee's 5-second call.
Number two.
Baseline drive, no good, kicked out to Powell. Oh, little backdoor pass. Nice find to Tyler Small, who gets the easy two under the basket.
Nice. Great little read there from the baseline cutter. Easy two finish. You got to need those easy scores in a championship game like this. How many can you get?
Distress finds his teammate Agu. Back out to Distress. Thinks about the shot. Drives baseline. Pulls up. Short two. A little bit short. And it's rebounded by Mohamed. Mohamed. Back to the other end. Tough take. No good. And there's Mohamed inside with the cleanup play. And early on, both teams really aggressive on the glass. That one goes out of bounds off Mohamed. And so it'll be a Haringey ball. St. Charles currently leading 4-2 after 1 minute of 30 action here at the Essex Arena. But end-to-end basketball to get us started.
Yeah, both these teams looking like they are not shy of the occasion, that is for sure. Come out aggressive right away.
Smith finds Newbury. Newbury goes inside. Nice take. Newbury with the right hand through the traffic.
Yeah, did a great job of protecting the ball there through the reaching hands of the defense. And managed to slip a nice easy one in for the two.
Mohamed inside. Somehow the ball rattles out to Powell for three. Very long on the shot. And Adedo gets a hand to it but tips it out of bound. So it's going to be a Haringey possession again.
Well, you look at both these teams here early on. There's a lot of length for both teams. So you can expect some high volume of deflections. And they're getting their hands on the basketball. The ball's popping around a little bit. Who corrals the ball and takes control and composure might come out on top here.
Nice floater inside from Leslie Smith. And Haringey take the first lead of the ball game. Three at the other end to answer back. No good. Adedo again trying to fight for that offensive board. He has been active so far for St. Charles. And Distress trying to get Haringey into their half-court offense. Comes off the screen, finds the roll. Another nice take from Adedo Newbury for Haringey. That's two layups straight down the middle of the lane for him.
Yeah, great middle ball screen there. And the diver was very aggressive. No hesitation, straight down the lane line. Catch him, finish.
Distress finds Agu, and there's a foul called. Foul's going on Tariq Powell. And that'll be our first foul of the game, and a cast to actually catch our breath a little bit after 3 minutes of end-to-end basketball. But both teams, as you said, Mark, neither team really showing any nerves. Both being super aggressive on the boards and attacking the basket. Haringey possession again. Paint touch off the glass.
That was tough.
Andreas Vela there, the 6 foot guard. Distress gets his hands on the ball for the steal at the other end. Distress can't make the layup with the right on the left hand side.
Yeah.
And a travelling violation called on Powell for St. Charles. So Haringey, after stretching their lead to 6, we get another opportunity to extend it here.
Yeah, you can see both teams are looking to really play in transition. They're not taking their time in half court, trying to find an easy option right away, playing with high speed and tempo, which is good. And here's another attack.
Agu kicks out. Vela back into Agu, back to basket move. Head fake goes up strong. Nice move by Franklin Agu.
Great composure and body control there from the big fella. He was able to gather his feet and endure the contact.
Adedo to the glass, but he answers at the other end.
Well, you can see he is trying to lay his stamp on the game right away. He's one to watch for this one.
Agu takes the bump. Nice pass out to the corner to Smith. Smith rattles home the three.
Inside, outside, penetrate, kick. Easy hoops, playing with high speed, like we said.
And there's Franklin Agu again, getting his hands on the deflection to just slow the St. Charles transition. There's a ball in the hands of Franco Jardil for St. Charles, trying to get them back into their offense again. Another tough take. Adedu. And he's going to go to the line to shoot two for our first free throws of the game. The foul's called on Franklin Agu. Just struggling ever so slightly to keep his man in front.
Number 7 is going to have two free throws.
And we've got a sub called St. Charles. Oh, we're going to sub out Tariq Powell, and coming in is Michael Ademola. It just looks ever so slightly, St. Charles are just going a little bit smaller. Dado makes the first at the line, trims that lead to 8, 15-7. Haringey lead with 5:54 remaining. And gets the second to go, so 15-8. Smith on the ball, finds a goo. Across to Vela, looks to penetrate, lane cut off, strong defensive stance, although I'm not sure it was a bit of a flop there. And another move inside for Newbury. Haringey so far being super aggressive in attacking the paint and getting whatever they want in the painted area. Who comes down with a rebound. Finds Vela. Vela kicks to the corner to Smith. Turns down another three. Gets inside the paint. Swarmed by the St. Charles defense.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see now if Haringey start to adjust. Obviously, the defense for St. Charles have started to really pack it in the paint on those drives.
And there's Adedo again to clean up the miss. Adedo up to 8 points personal of the 10 for St. Charles. So he's having his fingerprints all over the game for them, keeping them within touching distance of Haringey, who line up another three. No good. And the ball secured by Tyler Small. Here's that man Adedo again, going straight at Agu. Mohammed into the paint. Adjusts, but can't get the roll. And Haringey again, pushing the ball in transition.
Oh, good hands.
Mohammed throwing his body in, coming up with the ball somehow. Adedo again to the paint. And Adedo gets another one to go. And that's going to force a timeout. The head coach, Frank Batimba, for Haringey. And he's not happy with something as his team heads to the bench.
Well, let's talk about this Adedo young man real quick. He's obviously come to play today. He's somebody really that has stamped his authority on the game. I like him because he's really versatile. It looks like he can do a lot of different things. His size and athleticism is good to be able to attack the smaller defenders if they're matched up. But he also looks like he's got the size to shoot over the top of them when he's in the lane. And you can see he's got a good nose for the basketball, really trying to get his hands on every rebound possible to him. He is looking like one to watch for this one.
Definitely, Abidin Adedo coming into the game averaging 19.2 points and 6.9 rebounds. He's already up to 8 points and 3 rebounds personal.
And that's what you love about finals is there's always one guy that really gets after it, and there's always a couple X-factor guys that maybe their stats haven't been tremendously good throughout the year, but they come up in the moment, and it's the X-factor guy that maybe on the scouting report you're like, okay, try and limit any easy ones, and they just come up and have a big game. And I know that there will be somebody today who will be the surprise attack in all three of these finals.
Most definitely, and at the moment, it's looking like Adedo for St. Charles. He's really keeping them in this game as they only trail by 5 now, and there he is on cue. And an unsportsmanlike foul is called.
He's upset with that one. He was ready for takeoff. You can see he was ready to throw a slam dunk down there, get the crowd going, keep this run going for St. Charles.
And that foul is going to go on Dwedo Newbury for Haringey. And so Adedo is going to go to the line for 2 shots and possession. So this could be a huge play, especially out the back of the Haringey timeout for St. Charles. Knocks down the first with nothing but net. 17-13, 4:14 remaining. And makes the second. So what a possession this could be, as it's now a one possession ball game. St. Charles just weathering that Haringey storm ever so slowly. Looked like they're almost settling into the game now.
Yeah, they're chipping away here at that early lead that Haringey took. Good composure from them.
Powell inbounds. Akinbaye's driving lane's cut off. Ademola, though, has the lane, and he gets the right-handed layup to go with barely any resistance from the Haringey defense.
Well, his first step was incredible there. He's somebody we might be nicknaming Mr. Speed if he carries on like this. And there he is again.
And showing that speed perfectly for another coast-to-coast layup, and St. Charles take a 1-point lead for the first time since the first 2 minutes of the game.
Good stand.
Distress driving into the trees at St. Charles. And here he is again. No good inside. Nice pass to Adedo. And that's a three-point lead now for St. Charles. 17-20, they lead.
Nice run here from St. Charles. They're really... tough take.
Franklin Agu going to the Euro step to the basket. But how about end-to-end basketball still for both teams? Nice pass inside to find Josh Akinbaye, who gets another lefty layup at the side of the rim.
Well, I'm getting tired watching this. This is high-tempo hoops right here.
Agu finds Distress. Distress kicks out for three. Bang! Haringey answers straight back and ties up at 22 apiece.
Wow. I tell you what, these guys have really... not surprised me at all, but in terms of like being able to come out here in this moment and play this way, it's incredible. Credit to these guys. I'm looking forward. We're only 8 minutes into the game.
Adedo with the two there to give St. Charles their back to a two-point lead. Sorry, Distress on the ball for Haringey. No good inside. And here's Ademola to the basket again, just can't get the roll. And it's rebounded by Newbury. Smith now penetrating at the other end, again inside in the paint. Big rebound, Franklin Agu, and there he is to clean up. Franklin Agu out to 8 points personal now. And this really is end-to-end basketball. It's almost as if both coaches have said we're going to beat the other team by beating them in transition. Distress inside to Agu. Nice pass. Good find. Comes out to Young. Turns down the free. Finds Distress for free. No good. And rebounded again by that man, Adedo.
Finally, a half-court possession. We can take a breath. Oh, straight into it. Good attack.
Adedo can't get the finger roll to go. And it's rebounded by Newbury. All in the hands now of Owen Young for Haringey. Distress actually getting them into a half-court offense. Finds Agu, high post, Smith for three. Rims out, rebounded by Distress. Distress, nice up and under move. Big play from the young guard. And another tough take inside from Powell. Can't get it to go and rebounded again by the orange of Haringey. Distress kicks to the corner to Smith. Smith pulls up almost at the elbow. Adedo can't secure the rebound for St. Charles. It comes out to Young on the perimeter. Nine on the shot clock. Young has to make a move. Finds Agu. Agu's going to drive inside. Tough take and the and one. Franklin Agu has really started to stamp his authority on the offensive end for Haringey.
Yeah, it was a great take there from Agu. He just paused for that moment. That little bit of hesitation in the peak at the rim, it just froze the defense. And it allowed him to put the ball on the floor and get by them just in that moment where they paused. A great finish from him.
A great composure shown from him as well, with 4 seconds left on the shot clock. To not jack up the three from the corner and actually think, no, I'm going to get my shot, I'm going to go to the basket. And he gets the bonus point for the foul because of it.
And there's a lesson there for the young guys who are watching. Anytime you catch the basketball, anytime your fingertips touch leather, you should always peek at the rim. Make sure that the defense is ready to play you for that jump shot. Great job from him there.
Haringey stretched their lead out to 5 off the back of the Agu free throw. Mohammed can't secure the ball. Distress comes up with it. Distress finds Vella. Vella inside, swarmed by St. Charles players. So Tyler Small now with the ball for St. Charles. Finds Ademola, who again gets inside, is blocked. Sorry, that was Powell that he found that time.
Well, we're sat up at the top of the stands here, but I'm sure if we were courtside, the length of some of these young men is incredible. Both there on two block attempts, I was astonished by the sheer size and length and athleticism from these young men who are bringing it all today.
It's a timeout for Patrick Avilorki for St. Charles, but the thing that I've been most impressed by as well as the length is the verticality on the defensive end from all teams so far has been really good. Usually in the younger age group and within the ABL, the EABL, the WABL to a certain extent, you see teams always looking to reach in for the highlight play. They want to end up on Hoops Fix. They want to get plays of the week. But these guys, their defensive fundamentals so far has been great. They've been straight up. They've been vertical. And it's made it difficult for the two teams when they're driving into the paint to actually get up and finish at the rim. I say that we're 29-24, but they have done a great job defensively for me so far in that verticality.
Yeah, you can see these are two very well coached teams. There's a reason they're both here in the championship game. They're both teams that can really get after you defensively. They can both score in transition. There's a lot of second chance opportunities for athletic rebounding guys. So there's no surprise that both these teams are here looking at what they're showing on the floor so far. And like we said, I think who is more relentless and maybe composed. And I tell you, the battle of the turnovers, if you look after the ball and don't allow those easy scores from points off turnovers, that's going to be a big key in this one, the way that they've shaped up so far.
Oh, coming out of the timeout, St. Charles looking for the score. There's Powell for the three, gets it to go, and that's what you want as a coach, is your team to execute to perfection. As Distress just can't get the shot off at the end of the quarter.
That was a big, big possession right there. They go into the break down two, and it could have been five. And that was a great possession there from the after timeout play for the corner three to really keep it nice and tight here heading into the second quarter.
So at the end of end-to-end basketball, Haringey leading 29-27. But the story of the game so far has been Franklin Agu versus that man that we've not stopped talking about, Abidan Adedu, who has 16 points and 4 rebounds personal in the first quarter. But Franklin Agu looking to pace up with the 11 points personal and 4 rebounds. So neither of those two guys wanting to give this game away in the early going.
Yeah, you got to think as Haringey now, how are they going to quiet him down, Adu? And, you know, it's tough. Like we said, he's a very talented, versatile player. He's already got up to 16 points. But how are you going to now adjust and try to just slow him down a little bit? Maybe distance control, like, you got to find a way to... He's obviously gaining a lot of confidence, so you want to try and break that confidence in some way, maybe throw a different type of defense. Who knows? Let's see what they do. It's exciting to see who and how they're going to adjust in this second quarter.
And while we do have this chance, it's probably worthwhile to congratulate those guys that have come across in the ABL awards at the end of season. And no surprise that the two guys that we're talking about the most so far, Franklin Agu, most valuable player in the East, and then Adidan Adedu, as well as his teammate Mohamed, making the first team in the South for St. Charles. And not to count out Alex Distress for Haringey, who also made the first team as well. So we have a lot of players on display here today that have been recognized and won awards so far this season, or for the end of season awards, should I say.
Yeah, and you'd expect that, you know, so the talented players usually make championship games, and it's credit to all the work that they're putting in throughout the year. And now they get the opportunity to showcase one more game and try and finish for that team win and get that championship.
I think I also want to just shout out everyone that's made the journey to come and support today as well, because both teams have brought big support. We're starting to see some of the other teams that are competing across the day in the EABL and WEBL games trickling as well. But the support for a 1 o'clock game on a Wednesday is just phenomenal here. It's one side of the crowd's almost at capacity. We're starting to have to fill up the other side. As Agu, no good inside. And it's rebounded by Adedu. Mohamed in transition. Gets the Euro step around Agu. Comes up with his own rebound. Goes up strong and he's fouled.
That was a great take there. The way he slithered past the defense in that Euro step. Nice body control. Earns the right to get to the free throw line. Stayed in the play well as well. Was very relentless. Trying to grab his own offensive rebound put back.
Mohamed short on the first free throw. And no good on the second, and it's cleaned up by Agu. So Distress getting Haringey into their offense, coming straight downhill off a great screen, pulls up for two, in and out. There's Dwayne Nubri, who comes up with it, finds Agu, comes down like a freight train through the middle and gets the two to drop.
He's got an incredible touch, his size and strength and athleticism. A really, really nice touch around the rim. You see that nice, soft little hands and floaters that he's able to do, and those little layups that just hit the rim and seem to drop. He's doing a great job.
Agu picking up the blocking foul. That's his second personal. He's going to have to be careful now with 9 minutes 15 remaining. as Adedo looks to go inside, no good, and there is a goo cleaning it up, but he has to be careful now on two fouls not to pick up a third, because you would expect him to then sit for the rest of the half. The driving lane's cut off for Haringey. Distress finds Young back out to Distress from deep, no good, and it's rebounded by Tarek Powell. Powell looks to go coast to coast, but his driving lane's cut off, backs it out, goes back in. And a little bit too much sauce on that shot as it just hits the top of the backboard. Distress comes down with it. He's down at the other end. He can't answer. And Adedo comes down with the rebound.
Nice advance pass.
Powell inside. Great verticality again from Haringey. Powell finds Mohammed. Pulls up short. Banks it home. And that was a well-needed two for St. Charles to trim that lead back down to two, but after a few empty possessions on the offensive end. Young now finds Distress in the corner. Gets his defender on his heels. Back to Young. Young for his second triple of the game and extends that Haringey lead to five.
Nice. Both teams aren't letting up here. The pace is continuing. We're going back and forth, up and down. Quick shots, quick possessions. Second chance opportunities.
Young finds Agu. Agu inside, swarmed again by St. Charles players. How's he come down with that? And we've got a foul called. It looked like Dwedo Nubri had come up with the shot and had got the shot to drop, but there was a late whistle. And I think it's a foul that will send Franklin Agu to the free throw line. But I'm just amazed, Mark, how... And you said it there, how quick this game is. Even on a score, both teams, they're taking the ball out and they're advancing straight down the other team's throat and trying to get that transition score straight away. At some point, one of the coaches is going to have to look at the transition defense and just say, we want to slow the ball. Maybe look at a press. I know St. Charles threw that press in for a couple of possessions that kind of got them the lead, so maybe they go back to that. Trailing by five here, 7:44 left in the first half at the University of Essex.
Yeah, it's tough with two teams being so aggressive. You're always worried as a coach, and maybe if you press, you might give up some easy ones because they are being so aggressive. But, boy, you'd love to slow the opposition down in some way, shape, or form here.
Powell finds Adedu. Adedu looks inside, kicks it out to Jardil, finds Mohammed. And Mohammed's deflected out of bounds. So that'll stay with St. Charles. 13 left on the shot clock. Be Mohammed to inbound. Finds Adedo. Adedo looks to penetrate again. Nice Euro step. Nice.
I was just about to make a comment that he's been kept scoreless so far, and right on cue, he pulls out the big basket there to chip into the lead.
Young, no good on the rebound, but great offensive rebound by Newbury. Kicks out to Agu, squares up, finds Young again, given too much space for someone that's made two frees, but doesn't take it. Agu, spin move inside. And we've got another foul called under basket. But Franklin Agu so far is proving very difficult to contain. Seems to be getting to the paint and to the basket at will. So it's Newbury at the line to shoot two. 35-31, 7 minutes free left to go. Two fouls apiece for both teams. So for the next 7 minutes, if you're either of the coaching staffs, you're going to be saying to them, can we please try and play a little bit of defense without fouling? But a lot of them also come in on offensive boards, so they should really look to get the boards first and make sure they're boxing out and clearing out in order to just gain possession. And then they can get out into their running game, which we've seen so much of so far. Newbury, no good, but there's another offensive rebound for the guard, Young. And there's another foul called on the floor, I think.
Yeah, I was a little reach in there on the offensive rebound. Got to keep your hands out in those moments. Any slap down type action, the referees are hot on that.
And that foul on Tarek Powell, that's his fourth. Surely that can't be. Four fouls for Tarek Powell with 6:59 to go in the second quarter. That's huge for St. Charles. Oh, Newbury, nice catch and finish in the paint off an easy out-of-bounds play. Back in by, he finds a Adedu, drives in, takes the contact. What a finish. Abedida and Adedu, I mean, so far for me, has been the standout performer. He's up to 20 points personal. Distress gets on the two, can't get it to go. Rebounded by probably the smallest guy on the floor, Jardil. Small finds Jardil. Jardil kicks out to Akinbaye. Pulls up short corner. Nice shot.
Nice. Nice little boom step 1-2 there. An easy pull up. Great job of him knocking it down, being unbalanced. Nice little pull up too.
Young throws the fake, gets past Mohammed, finds Agu just inside the 3-point line. No good. And there's that man Newbury again, all over the offensive boards. He's a real problem. Agu finds him and rewards him for his offensive boards.
It's been nice to see those little, when you engage a defender and they make the little extra shuffle pass. There's been a couple of them so far. So guys, they're prepared to make the extra pass for the open teammate. They're not trying to force shots up, which sometimes you might do in a championship game, but they've been very unselfish, which has been good to see for those easy scores around the rim.
Agu that time guarded really well by Mohammed, who stood his ground and forced Agu into the miss. And off the deflection, it's going to be a St. Charles ball. But neither team really pulling away from the other. They've both had runs in the first 15 minutes of action here in Essex, but both of them, whenever one team goes on a run, they seem to answer straight back. And here's Mohammed now for St. Charles. Finds a Adedu again, penetrating, goes straight at Newbury. And yeah, that's a foul on Newbury as he came down onto the shooter. So Adedu is going to go to the line for another two free throws. He's 4 for 4 at the line so far, shooting 100%. And 8 for 13 from the field. So he's having a great game. The St. Charles, and is a big reason why they're still within touching distance of Haringey. Makes the first, trims that lead down to 3, one possession game.
Well, there's 5 minutes to go here in the second quarter, and he might reach his season average by halftime. Currently sitting at 15 points. He might be up there to 19 a game. He'll be there before the half.
Haringey now in the hands of Agu, stripped by Adedu. Akinbaye, what a little hop step finish for St. Charles, and we're all tied up at 39 apiece. Agu, corner. Kicks out to Vella. Vella back to Agu. Agu uses his strength inside. Players bouncing off him.
Like a pinball machine in there. Guys just bouncing away. Doing a great job using his size and advantage down low. Staying relentless in the play. He is a tough cover.
Looking at the rosters for today, Franklin Agu listed at 6'3", but he plays much bigger than 6'3". His strength and presence in the paint and ability to get to the front of the basket for a finish, as you say, is just phenomenal. And here he is on cue now, pulls up for 2 this time. Front rims it, no good, it's rebounded. St. Charles again looking to push in transition. Oh. Adedu can't get that one to drop. That would have been St. Charles' first lead since midway through the first. And we have an offensive foul called. That one's going to go on Leslie Smith, just trying to force his way to the basket. A great defensive stance from St. Charles, who sub in Tyler Small, and Mohammed heads to the bench.
Well, interestingly here for Haringey, Distress is back in the ball game. He's been very good defensively. He's been in the passing lanes. He's got 2 steals already in the game. He's been a bit of a nightmare in terms of that perimeter defense. So let's see if he can get a couple more steals and easy 2s. I'm sure there's a reason. That's the reason he's back in the game.
Yeah, averaging 3 steals a game as well, so showing that he's been a defensive stopper all season long. The Dado goes straight at the Haringey defense, but can't get that one to go. He's just starting to struggle now a little bit at the rim. Haringey doing a much better job of big foul there by Adedu, who wraps up Distress, but doesn't allow him to get the shot. I was just saying, Haringey doing a much better job of putting bodies in front of Adedo now whenever he's driving to the basket to just limit him so that he sees orange every time he's going to the basket, whereas before he was just seeing clear lanes and getting easy scores left and right.
He's looking a bit winded too at the moment, and that may have been a fatigue foul there. He wasn't able to get back to the paint and get in front and use his length. Unfortunately, he was caught behind and reaching there. So it'll be interesting to see how he finishes this first half.
Distress at the line, long on it. Somehow the ball comes back to him. He gets inside.
Oh.
A foul called, but he passes the ball off to Agu. So the referee says no basket. The foul goes on Tyler Small for St. Charles. And Distress will go to the line for another two. Both teams now in the penalty for the rest of the way as well, with 4 minutes and 9 seconds left to go.
Well, that's always the story in any game, let alone a championship game. Can you knock down the bonus free throws?
Distress gets the first to drop.
And then we're sure to see a number of trips to the free throw line here with a long 4 minutes remaining.
And the second, so Haringey retake the lead, 41-39. Adedu guarded really tightly by Haringey, somehow manages to get it to his teammate who stops and pops. And that's Tyler Small inside for two. Young at the other end, shaking and baking, but can't shake Mohammed. Finds Distress. Distress again gets into the paint. Not enough on the finger roll. Ball rattling around in there somehow. And here's that man, Adedu, who comes up with it. Advance pass, kick back. Small again, this time for three. No good, rebounded by Young, but Small chasing the offensive boards, chasing his own shot, so showing some real hustle and desire. Distress for Haringey. Finds Agu. Back to Distress, sees the lane, baseline. Adjusts midair, but can't get the roll on the layup. And Mohammed, ooh, slight push off in transition. Gets into the paint, finds Adedu.
Stay in the play, young fella. Great job.
And that's Abarge inside. Sorry, the one and the seven on the St. Charles kit looking very similar. Abarge coming in and making an impact as he gets the two to drop on the and one. And St. Charles retaking the lead, 43-41. 3 minutes left to go.
41-43 in favor of St. Charles.
Abarge can't get the bonus free throw to drop. Haringey looking to answer. Young blocked by Adedo.
He's doing it all out there.
Mohammed comes up with the offensive boards and cleans up the miss. St. Charles lead out to four now. Young again guarded really tightly by Mohammed. Again shakes him, finds a goo. Distress up high, comes off the screen from Agu, pulls up for two inside the 3-point line. nothing but net for Distress.
Back and forth we go, high scoring game, loads of possessions, high tempo. Here's another drive and another trip to the free throw line.
Adedo fouled, so he's going to go to the line for another two. And this game really not slowing down at all for either team.
Talked about it the last time he was at the free throw line. He has surpassed his season average. He's now at 22 points, looking to go to 24 here with the extra two shots coming. He's been an extremely impressive player so far in this ball game. And there's still another 22 minutes to go. I wonder what his stat line is going to be at the end of this game. Could be a huge one. In all areas, he is stat stuffing right now. 23 points, 6 rebounds, 1 assist, 1 steal, 1 block. He's doing it all.
Interestingly, he's only a 62% free throw shooter as well. He's shooting 100% so far. So he has definitely come to play when it matters most. Rebounded by Ebaje. Small, getting his head down and heading straight into the paint. Jardil comes up with a rebound. Can't get the floater to go, and we've got another foul called on the baseline. That foul's going to go on Tyler Small, who reached in on Agu on the rebound. And the referee deems that it wasn't a 50-50 ball, so Agu had possession, so he's going to go to the line to shoot two.
Well, you can see both teams here playing a very similar brand of basketball, and they are extremely relentless on the glass, both teams. Both are in double digits for second chance points. St. Charles sitting at 13 second chance points. And Haringey at 16. So you got to think this second half coming up, who's going to win the battle of the boards? That could be a massive key to the ball game.
Agu at the line, made his first. Doesn't make his second. There's another offensive rebound. Both teams wrap it up. And jump ball is the call. St. Charles will regain possession. Almost on cue, crashing the glass. But both teams' coaches are going to be really happy with the fact that they're crashing the glass. They're not going to be happy with their defensive rebounding and the fact that they're giving up that many offensive boards. So I just wonder if that's something that they'll look at in the halftime break and just really emphasize, guys, we've got to put bodies on them. Mohammed comes out of almost a triple team, gets to the rack and gets the two to drop.
Boy.
Young for Haringey. Smith can't quite handle it, finds Agu. Distress again from deep, drills the triple!
Big time shot, that was deep too.
It was almost at the volleyball line as Young comes up with the... Oh! From Adeno!
He said, not today, young fella!
And the crowd on the far side from us is going crazy for the St. Charles defense. Owen Young came up with a steal, thought he had the easy left-hand layup, and out of nowhere, Adedo flies in to say, no, no, not today.
He thumped it into the front row there. Media people got to look out and dodge the ball. It's coming their way.
Couple of expensive laptops and cameras sat on that table as well. But in the meantime, we have a timeout. 47-49, St. Charles have retaken the lead in the last few minutes and they're not giving it back to Haringey despite their best attempts. 1:06 remaining in the first half. And we're going to have to talk about that man, Adedo, at 24 points personal, 6 rebounds so far. I mean, he's shooting 8-for-14 from the field. We did touch on it ever so slightly midway through the quarter that Haringey are doing a much better job of just putting bodies in front of him now. But how can Haringey slow him in this last remaining minute and then the second half?
Well, it's tough because the game has been played at such a high tempo. There's so many possessions. There's bodies flying in from all over the place. It's hard to see the crashing guys when you're half in help and you're half playing your men. But in some way, shape or form, guys have got to try and keep the opponents off the glass. Because they're flying in there for second chance points.
So baseline possession.
That's what's tough with so many drivers, and that's obviously been the tone that's been set. So you are in the lane trying to help out a little bit, trying to shrink the floor. And another 3-point shot. He's heating up. And here we go. Can they pack the paint whilst also checking the cutters that are crashing in?
Small head fake. Finds Ebaje, throws up the triple, no good. Rebounded by Adedu. Kicks out. Mohammed again on the drive. Mohammed takes the contact. And he's going to go to the line to shoot two. Fouls called on Owen Young for the block. So Mohammed will head to the free throw line. He's 0-for-2 at the free throw line so far. But supporting his teammate Adedo pretty well with 6 points personal, 6 rebounds, 2 of them offensive to go along with 3 assists. You can guarantee all 3 of those have been to Adedo. And Mohammed drills the first, so ties us up at 50 apiece. Pretty high scoring affair as well for 42 seconds till halftime at 50 apiece for both of these teams. But I guess that comes as a byproduct of the pace that they set in the early going in that first quarter.
Yeah.
Mohammed doesn't get the second to go, rebounded by Agu.
if they carry on like this for the next 20 minutes, it could be both teams over 100 points quite easily.
Agu, high post, finds Smith. Smith can't get the right-handed layup to go. St. Charles are going to have... there's two more possessions left in the game. Just a few seconds separating game and shot clock. And that's not what you want. Akinbaye throws it out of bounds, just anticipating the cut.
Well, here we go here. 17 seconds left. Tied ball game. Timeout called. You really got to value this possession. See if you can go into the halftime break with some sort of advantage, whether it's a trip to the free throw line, an easy two, a wide open three. You got to try and find some way, shape or form to just go into that locker room with a little bit of momentum here for Haringey.
And interestingly, that's a St. Charles timeout to set up their defense against Haringey. So had the extra timeout, and head coach Patrick Avolika deciding that he's going to take it.
It'll be interesting to see here if he comes out with a different look defensively. He might zone up.
And as they're talking through that timeout for Haringey, interesting to see what they're going to come out with in the second half. Whether they go quick or whether they look to...
I don't think there's any slowing down these teams. That's for sure.
Whether they look to actually drag out the 16 seconds and get the last shot to head in with a lead.
Well, we might be seeing a little bit of zone here from St. Charles. It looks like it, the way they're set up here. Coming out with a different look out of the timeout. Yep, a little 3-2 zone.
Agu comes to the high post, sets the screen for Distress. Distress finds Smith. Smith penetrates, stripped away by Adedo. Finds Smith. Oh, the layup to go. And that's a fitting end to the first half as we finish at 50 apiece. All tied up.
It was almost the perfect situation there coming out of the timeout for St. Charles. They did change their defense, sat in that zone, managed to get the stop, the breakaway layup, but couldn't quite get it to go. But what a half of basketball. These two teams here in the championship really representing the ABL tremendously. High tempo, high pace, looking forward to the next 20 minutes.
As both teams on your screens head out to the locker room, we're going to take a short 5-minute break and then we'll be back for second half action here at the University of Essex. Don't go anywhere.
the coach of the year for the WEABL. So when I call out their names, I want to hear plenty of round of applause for the person who has won. So for the Southern Conference, it is Jackson Gibson of Kuna. Keep the round of applause going, guys. Come on, keep it going. Okay, up next we have the Defensive Player of the Year from the WEABL Song Conference, Esther Little from Coppersley. Where are you going, girl? Esther. Come on, girl.
Drop it like it's hot.
welcome back to the University of Essex and the Essex Arena for this ABL action between Haringey and St. Charles, where we are tied up at 50 apiece in what has been an end-to-end game of basketball action so far. Expecting this second half to be no different. Story of the first half has very much been the transition game for both teams, but it's also been a big-time battle between Franklin Agu, who sits on 15 points personal to go along with 12 rebounds at the half, versus Abidaiden Adedu, the 6'5 forward, who has 24 points personal to go along with 8 rebounds. Those two have been dueling so far for Haringey and St. Charles, respectively. So, third quarter action about to get underway. My name is Liam Jefferson. I'm joined by Loughborough University head coach Mark Jarram, who will be with me throughout the day. And it'll be Haringey to inbound and get us underway.
Well, Franklin Agu sitting at a double-double with 20 minutes remaining. And how about a shout-out, if you're listening, Obi Agu, his older brother, a former EABL winner at Barking Abbey. If you're listening to the live stream, drop us a comment. Shout-out to you, young men. Your brother's doing a great job. Looking forward to seeing what he's going to do here this second half of basketball.
And here he is, right on cue. First possession. St. Charles giving him the drive to the baseline, but then cut away on the ice. Distress still with the ball. Finds Agu. Shot clock down to 7. Kicks to Smith in the corner. Young turns down the three-pointer. Pulls up at the free-throw line. No good. And rebounded by Agbaje. Small penetrating. Lane cut off by Distress, though. Agbaje inside for 2. Nice start for St. Charles with a good score at the rim. Oh, Haringey looking to answer. Smith with the ball. Smith finds Young. Young pulls up from deep. Short on the free, and it's rebounded by Akinbaye. Mohamed screaming for the ball in transition, but Akinbaye didn't see him. Small pulls up for 3. And Adedo cleans up with the offensive board and another 2.
Yeah, great job from him. An easy rebound, and he didn't hesitate. It was a quick catch and straight back up. Nice touch off the window.
Young finds Smith. Smith fakes the pass, drives inside. No good. Both teams battling for the boards. It didn't look to me like anyone really had possession of the ball. But a jump ball is called, and St. Charles have the possession arrow, so they'll get it back. Small looking to get St. Charles into their offense. And Zakimbaye across to Adedo, finds Mohamed. Small jab step, drives, dump off pass to Mohamed. Tough take by Mohamed. And St. Charles stretch their lead out to 6 in the first 2 minutes of the third quarter.
Oh, nice.
Newbury inside, answers right back.
Great movement on penetration there from the big under the basket. Saw his teammate getting into the middle of the paint. Move to make a nice passing opportunity. Was able to catch and finish.
I was about to say St. Charles had their biggest lead of the game, but that point was trimmed down quickly by Newbury as Agu goes inside to answer back. No good. Tapped out by Small. Not sure why he didn't just corral that rebound. Akinbaye so shifty. Gets into the paint, but can't get the finish. As Distress goes at the other end and answers straight back. And that's how you do finish at the rim.
Well, both teams aren't letting up. There's no chance of slowing them down. Both teams continue to be aggressive, get into the paint. Nice little dump up. Oh, baseline jam.
And it's Agbaje who gets us our first dunk of the game. Smith finds Young wide open. Knocks down the triple, his third of the game, Owen Young.
Can't leave him open. Nice stroke. Any catch and shoot, you got to make sure you can run him after the three-point line.
Mohamed. And one called. I thought that was a little bit 50-50, to be honest. Both of them making the contact, but Mohammed is going to go to the line to shoot one. And that is the third foul on Franklin Agu, who just goes and chats to Mohammed at the free throw line. The two of them having a little bit of something to say to each other.
That's what's great about the game now in this age, in terms of a lot of players really know each other. They've been around, and we'll see that in the WEABL and the EABL finals. Like, a lot of these guys know each other. They play each other in national leagues on the weekend. And they have the opportunity to, you know, in those dead moments, to probably talk to each other and talk a little trash. But they're coming out here and being fierce competitors, that's for sure.
Oh, Distress is going to go to the line to shoot two after the foul by Mohammed. And it was Mohammed's first foul. So Distress at the line.
Distress puts up his first.
Doesn't make the first.
Off the rim.
Distress a 75% free throw shooter on the season.
Distress for a second.
Does get that one to drop.
It's a 2-point game.
Oh, Distress only shooting 50% for the game, usually up at 75%.
Odedo.
Odedo guarded really tightly by Leslie Smith there, who wraps the ball up. And we've got a jump ball called.
Leslie Smith, the young man that hit that game-winning three at the buzzer in the semi-final there, Haringey and Stoke-on-Trent. Coming up with the stop there.
Distress on the ball. Nice pass inside. Nubu went up to flush it home. And we have a jump ball called as Mohammed and Nubri wrapped each other up. That's our third jump ball in 3.5 minutes. Neither team wanting to give up any possession now. They both know how important every single possession is. Mohammed finds Jardil. Small, no good. Smith gets the deflection. Shot clock down to 10 because it didn't hit the rim. Odedo, no good. Rebounded by Nubri over the top of St. Charles' players. Smith down the other end. A huge block for Odedo. But there's Nubri to follow up. My goodness. Abida and Odedo coming through for another huge block. But in those situations, everybody has to then jump and pounce on the ball. And Nubri was the first one to it. Dwayne Nubri will go to the line on the and one to give Haringey, if he makes this, their first lead of the second half. And this really has been back and forth. Neither team's led by more than five. And whenever one team goes on a run, the other team just seems to turn it up and answer straight back again. Agu comes up with the offensive boards, powers his way up inside. And there's another jump ball. You got to credit these young men on the floor. They really are valuing every single possession.
Yeah, that's what it takes in these championship games. Any loose balls, any 50-50 battles, you really got to come out on top.
Distress in the corner. Thinks about it, pulls up. No good. Nubri comes up with the offensive board. Somehow gets that to go from behind the basket. And Dwayne Nubri has been a big impact in this second half for Haringey. Distress called for the foul.
Oh, that was tough. He caught the ball well below the backboard there, right along the baseline, and he had the dexterity to turn around and find the basket. Tough little finish from him.
Yeah, Nubri up to 14 points and 12 rebounds. Five of those rebounds on the offensive end, but even more impressive is he's shooting 87% from the field. Only missed one shot so far in the game.
Yeah, he's getting a lot of attempts around the rim, doing a good job of that inside the paint scoring.
Just gets in the way there of Agu, who called for the ball. Agu goes up. Foul called. And a foul called on number one. That's on Shea Agbaje. And Agbaje is going to head to the bench. Mohammed checking back in after a short break.
Franklin Agu, one guy I wouldn't want to defend when he's coming at you full speed. That is a big boy coming.
Sitting on 15 points, sorry, and 14 rebounds. This is the first chance to extend the lead to 3. No good, short. There's Newbury. Newbury, left hand finish would have done it. Just fading away from the basket. Jardil in the corner, no good. Loose ball somehow. Smith comes up with it, finds Distress. Distress going 1-on-4 at the other end. Finds Newbury. Newbury gets into the paint. What a take. Do we do Newbury?
Great find there from Distress. He jumped into pass where he found his teammate. And again, that little peek, it paused the defense and he was able to get to the rim.
Mohammed crashes into Agu. And rightly so, a travel is called on Mohammed. Mohammed, what a defensive possession by Franklin Agu. Keeping his hands out, his body nice and low. And staying in front of Mohammed, not to give him the driving lane. That's a phenomenal defensive possession. So Young on the ball for Haringey. Finds Newbury. Newbury looking to force his way into the paint. Finds Distress, turns down the free, pulls up. I think there was a piece on that by Akinbaye. And Adam Mola is fouled by Smith. That'll be a sideline possession for St. Charles.
Mr. Speed, who's going so fast, he almost forgot the ball there.
Michael Adam Mola. We saw the impact he made in the first half when he came in and changed up a couple of possessions for St. Charles. With that speed, as Mohammed pulls up at the elbow. In and out, no good, rebounded by Agu. Distress flying into, I don't really know where he was flying into there. It's Adamola, gets into the paint, tough finish. Adamola just takes a slip as he tries to run back on the defensive end, but pulls St. Charles back within 2 points, 3 minutes 47. Young at the other end, and an M1 is called. Owen Young showing he's more than just a three-point shooter for Haringey as he gets to the rack, finishes with the left hand, and he'll go to the line for a bonus.
Having a great game here, impacting, winning. Definitely shooting the ball from the perimeter. And team's being a little bit more aggressive on his closeouts in that situation, able to get to the rim. And timeout taken.
Owen Young up to 11 points personal in 20 minutes for Haringey. Go along with 5 rebounds from the guard spot as well. Listed at 5'10 as a guard. I think he might be a little bit bigger than that, but he's definitely showing it on the boards. But neither team really having the opportunity to pull away from each other. We've talked about it a few times now. St. Charles came out of the half, went straight up by 5, but Haringey weathered that storm and have then come back again at the other end. So it's going to be one of those games, I think, where it's probably going to go down to the wire. It all depends on, can you get stops, and then can you convert those stops in transition or make good decisions on the offensive end in the half court. So really intriguing to see which way this one's going to go. It is a game of runs, and we've seen that so far.
Yeah, I think in these championship games, in these championship moments, the C word, the composure factor, is going to be huge. As both teams, it looks like it's going to go down to the wire unless one team makes a run here in the last remaining 13 minutes. But if it does go down to be kind of one possession type game the rest of the way, those valuing the possession, valuing the ball, finding good high quality shots, all comes down to the composure factor.
3 minutes 46 on the clock.
Young at the free throw line for his additional point. Gets it to go. Akinbaye, nice pass inside to Adamola.
In a Haringey defense there, fell asleep and was able to throw it over the top of the defense with the easy outlet and score.
Young kicks out to Vela, no good. Rebounded by Adedo. Mohamed tries to make the pass. Adedo comes up with a loose ball, drives into Young. Takes the contact. Ademola can't finish on the left-hand side. No need to fade away in that situation. And Young's going down at the other end. Vela finds Smith, finds Young, thinks about the three, turns it down, pulls it out this time, drills it, Owen Young! And Haringey extend their lead to six. Talk about turning down the easier one for the more difficult contested shot.
Well, you got to always have a hand up on him. That's a key in these type of games. You have to adjust as the game's going. Work out people's tendencies, and his tendency is to shoot the three, so you got to try and take that away, take away his primary threat. Hand down, man down, they say.
Adedo going at Smith. Adedo fouled, gets a shot up, and he's going to go to the line for two. Foul there called on Leslie Smith. And that'll be Smith's third of the foul. Both teams now in the penalty at four apiece. So the next one will send them to the free throw line. But we've got a timeout called. And Haringey's head coach, Frank Matimba, not happy again with something.
Well, one thing he will be happy with is the offensive rebounding from Agu and Newbury. They're both total rebounds. They're both sitting at 16 rebounds apiece. Four offensive for Agu and a massive eight offensive rebounds for Newbury. So 50-50, eight offensive, eight defensive, total of 16 here for Newbury as we head into the clutch stretch here of the third quarter and into what is going to be an exciting and entertaining last 10 minutes of play.
And you'll see as well here at the University of Essex, we got a really big turnout from both teams' supporters as the camera pans over the crowd for both teams. But great to see such great support for these two ABL teams, both making the short trip across from their respective colleges.
Yeah, you can see a sea of orange there, a few orange t-shirts for the Haringey crowd. And we'll see, will there be an X factor in terms of the sixth man in the fourth quarter?
So 70-64, 2:28 remaining in the third quarter. And it's going to be Abididen Adedu at the line for two shots.
And he still falls.
Makes the first.
We have three finals here today, Liam. We're all looking forward. This is the first of three.
Yes, indeed. We've got the WEBL game between City of London Academy and Charnwood College coming up at 3:15. And then Charnwood College men's team take on Barking Abbey School in the EABL game at 5:30. Both of those games will also be broadcast on YouTube, so make sure you stay with us for those games. Meantime, third quarter action, third quarter, couple of minutes left. St. Charles can't get the shot to go as Newbury blocks it, but only trailing by four to Haringey. And a big three to trim it to one.
Well, you can see Franklin Agu there. He's grimacing a little bit. He came up stumbling and hobbling on the way back there in that possession. So it'll be interesting to see if he can carry on. But you can see there's definitely something that's upsetting him. He's looking at the bench. And there's no way you want to bring him out of the game. He's going to try and figure it out. Well, I don't know if it was his knee or his ankle, but he definitely doesn't look right since he came up from that play.
And he has gone the whole way so far. So 28 minutes of action for Franklin Agu. Adedo's driving lane cut off, finds Mohamed. Kicks to Ademola in the corner. Looking by, he finds Ademola. Ademola turns on the jets, gets to the basket. Can't get the finish though, and it's rebounded again by Newbury. Vela finds Newbury on the trail. Across to Agu. Owen Young thinks about the free again. Oh. Takes one contested. Oh. Again, gets it to go. Owen Young loves a contested three-point shot as that's his second.
Well, when you're feeling it, you're feeling it. And I think that's his fifth three-point make. Way to go, young fella.
St. Charles trying to answer at the other end. Can't get it to go. Owen Young, 5 for 7 from three. Newbury inside, find the hot hand. There he is for another one.
Oh,
no good. This time rebounded by Adedu. Stripped away by Smith. Smith with a slight push.
Get it to the hot hand. Get it to the hot hand. Give him the ball.
Newbury
shoot
Bella
it.
Finds Young. Young finds Agu. Agu deemed to have travelled.
No basket.
Wow.
That's Owen Young.
Two tough threes with a defender right there in front of him. Highly contested. Thought about it. Shook the defender a little bit. A little bit of a jab series. Lets it fly. Two tough makes of his five.
18 points personal for Owen Young. Such X-factor points off the bench for Haringey, helping them to their four-point lead over St. Charles. Down into 20 seconds left to go. What a block, Leslie Smith. Newbury comes up with it, though, loses the handle. And there's a foul called on the floor, I think. Yep, foul called. It's going to be on number 12, Leslie Smith. And they're in the team fouls, so St. Charles will go to the line. That could be a huge possession. And that's... it's the fourth foul.
Well, a big factor here in this game, and something that we've got to keep an eye on in this up-and-coming fourth quarter, is the battle of the perimeter. So Haringey have made 8 for 16 from the three-point line, whereas St. Charles have only made 2 threes. So there might be an adjustment there. Do you want to dare St. Charles to shoot the three and really pack it in and protect the paint and protect those driving lanes? Whereas with Haringey, you've got to do a bit of both. They've obviously got the three-point threat and the driving threat and the rebounding threat. So it'll be interesting to see any adjustments made.
Newbury drives hard to the basket and there's a foul called. My apologies. The last foul was actually on Newbury as well. That's his fourth personal for Haringey.
Ooh.
That could be a big decisive factor in the outcome of this game.
He has been a monster for them today. He's been tremendous on the glass. He's been tremendous getting to the free throw line. And also just his ability to finish in and around the basket. If he has to sit down at any point in this fourth quarter, and as a coach, you want your main guys to be out there, but you also want to protect them. So him sitting on four fouls is going to be an interesting one to manage.
7 seconds left.
Small going coast to coast.
What a three! He must have heard me talking about the three-point line. He said, "We ain't got two, we got three now." Big shot. And again, right as the break happened, it's become a two-point ball game.
Dado with his first three of the game. Takes him up to 31 points personal to go along with 15 rebounds. However, at the half, we were talking about him sat on 24. So they've actually limited him a lot better in this second half.
Well, what really jumps off the page is he is 10 for 10 from the free throw line. 100% from the free throw line. That's incredible. So 10 of his 31 points all coming from the charity stripe.
And we talked about it before. He averages 2.5 made free throws a game, 4 takes for 62%. So he has absolutely eclipsed that and shown some real aggression going to the basket. And that's what's keeping St. Charles in this game for me. He's been the decisive factor. There's been some big performances elsewhere. Mohamed also supporting him on 11 points and 8 rebounds. But the primary bulk of St. Charles' work coming from their starting five, only getting 15 points from their bench and actually only rotating really 6 or 7 guys.
Yeah, well, big-time players show up in big-time games, and he is obviously a big-time performer. Rightfully so, earning some recognition in the awards this year, and you can really see why he is a most valuable player. And he's up there. If St. Charles win this game, it's only going to one player so far.
Most definitely. However, I don't think we can call which way this one's actually going to go. 75 to 73. So we get a shot there of Frank Matimba just talking to the referees as we head into the fourth quarter of action here at the University of Essex.
Well, Haringey quite oppositely. They've got four guys in double digits, really sharing the scoring at 20 points, 15 points, 15 points, 18 points, doing a good job of everybody impacting the game. And then those little X factor chippy ones, 5-2-2, really sharing the workload.
Mohamed, no good. Tariq Powell there with the box out. And that'll be Haringey ball. Not sure why he didn't grab that. Powell back into the game for his first action since the first quarter, where he picked up four fouls. Sorry, second quarter. It was 2 minutes into the second quarter when he picked up his fourth.
Oh, good fake.
He looks to go up with it. He's got a dado up in the air. You want to try and finish through that, get some contact, and go to the free throw line. It'll be a Haringey ball to inbound. Smith looks like he's heading for the ball. So Smith to inbound. Haringey leading by two. Smith into Newbury. Newbury guarded by Mohamed. Goes straight by him though. Can't get the finish. Comes out to Agu. 10 on the shot clock. Spins. Big body inside. Franklin Agu comes down with his own boards. Back up again. And a foul called.
Oh.
And both teams' coaches, one asking for the foul, the other asking, well, why was that a foul? So one of them has to be wrong somewhere.
Tough gig as a referee. You're always upsetting somebody.
So it's Agu at the line. We've got a sub as Josh Akinbaye comes in. Franco Jardil heads to the bench for St. Charles.
Now Franklin Agu doing what he does best. Takes up a lot of space under the rim there. He's able to corral the rebound, stay in the play really well. It's hard to get around him. He's so strong, and he does a great job of staying low and balanced. He's able to make fakes, get guys up in the air, and finish over the top or get to the free throw line.
Splits his free throws and extends the Haringey lead to three. So it's still a one possession game. St. Charles in the hands of Small. Hands off to Powell. Wow. Gets to Akinbaye. Tries to go baseline, but the lane's cut off by Agu. Adedo. Shot clock down to five. Mohamed has the ball. He's got to put a shot up. I'm not sure he knows it. Small manages to get free off. Doesn't hit anything. Although Haringey already had possession. And that means that they can go straight down the other end. Newbury again on the offensive boards, and he's fouled again. At some point, someone has to box this man out.
Yeah, you get to a stage where, especially, I don't know what his total offensive rebounds are, but I can tell you it's a lot. It comes to that stage where you're just like, hey, don't worry about anything else. Just box him out. You're in a one-on-one battle with him. Don't worry about help. Keep him off the glass.
This is ninth offensive rebound. 18 total for the game.
Unbelievable. Almost in double digits of offensive rebounds. That's an incredible job from him.
Yeah, he's only a couple away from a 2020 game. It'll be a huge impact on the game from the big man. So the Haringey lead still free. Powell gets called for the travel, and he made it as well.
He did shuffle his feet there a little bit on the catch.
What a backbreaker that is. That would have tied it up. And we were talking about how St. Charles needed some three-point shooting to keep them in this game, the way that Haringey was shooting the ball. And to get called for the travel. They need a big defensive stop here to keep it at a one-possession game. Newbury has it up high. And Adedo reaches in. He's contesting that one quite vigorously. It was most definitely a foul as he reached in on Newbury trying to penetrate past him.
That puts him on his third personal foul. Somebody that you definitely want to keep an eye on and make sure he's on the floor the way he is playing. MVP level type performance.
Agu kicks out. Agu again, spins again, kicks out. This just no good again. And Haringey just struggling at the moment to extend their lead. St. Charles' defense doing a really good job of keeping them in the game. Powell this time for free. This time he gets his footwork right. This time he drills it.
Now I tell you what, for him to sit out of the game for so long, he took four early fouls. He's sat for pretty much two quarters of basketball. He's come in here in the fourth, not afraid of the moment. Big time stuff.
Magu answers at the other end with the baseline penetration. Mohammed just a little bit late on his rotation to help. That means Haringey's lead back out to two. Tyler Small kicks out to Akinbaye for three. No good, rebounded by Smith. Young pulls it back out, recognizing he had a one-on-three situation. Nice Smith, Newbury, high post. Newbury gets his footwork right. Nice move from the big man on the offensive boards again, and he gets it to go. How about that from Dwido Newbury?
That's backbreaker stuff again. Comes back down to you've got to recognize the way the game's going, what players are doing, and just try and be a bulldozer and make contact with him and get him away from the rim.
Mohammed hits the wall that is Newbury on the defensive end. Haringey now leading 80-76, just over 7 minutes remaining in the game. Ball in the hands of Franklin Agu, comes off the Newbury screen. Nice roll from the big man. And a foul is called on the floor.
Great pass from Agu there, showing that he has the perimeter skills to make that play. Good vision.
Foul goes on Tyler Small, that's his fourth personal. St. Charles now sitting with Mohammed, Tyler Small and Tariq Powell, all on four fouls. And those three guys have all had a really big impact on the game for St. Charles, so you won't really want to lose any of them. As Agu goes inside and takes the foul for the and one. And this could be a big call. That one's going on a Dado. That's his fourth personal. So now four guys for St. Charles, all which have been big impacts. We have a long way to go, 6 minutes, 51 seconds.
Well, now I look up at the scoreboard and you see the team foul situation. St. Charles sitting on 5 team fouls. Haringey on 0. So it's going to be a factor either way. Obviously, there's some key guys in foul trouble, but also if it is a tight one, Haringey have a lot of fouls to give up before they get into a fouling situation to try and stop the clock.
And they've also extended their lead out to 7, their biggest of the second half. As here's Powell again for three to keep them within touching distance. Tariq Powell, what an impact this second half.
Well, that's unbelievable. I don't know, I talked about it before, but for him to sit out the majority of the game, you can see what they were missing. The three-point threat from Powell, 2 for 2 in this fourth quarter.
Oh, my God! Owen Young answers back with what I thought was a ridiculously contested three. It turned out to be a foul. He gets it to go. And one. And that's the fifth foul on Mohammed, who now has to sit. That could be a hugely decisive play in this ABL final.
Oh, my goodness. No shot is a bad shot for this young man. No shot. He's taking wide open ones. He's taking highly contested ones. He's taking ones he's getting fouled on. Unbelievable job. Great shooting performance from him today. Now let's see if he can make it a 4-point play here.
Ah, no good. Burt takes him to 21 points personal for the game from the bench as well. Zach Mbaye tries to shake and bake. Can't get the finish though. And Young has it again for Haringey. Just slows them into a half-court offense.
Well, Haringey got a little bit of momentum here. You can see that trying to...
Newbury drives inside.
Wow.
Takes the contact. Gets the two to drop.
9-point lead.
Tyler Small finds Tariq Powell, who goes to the basket. And Tariq Powell... huge impact from him. He's keeping St. Charles within touching distance. Trailing by 9 at the moment. He's going to go to the line to shoot 2. That's also the first team foul on Haringey. So you're going to want to try and drum up a couple more of those.
Well, big teaching moment for him in terms of his basketball career here today. Obviously, picking up those 4 early fouls. How might the game have shaped up if he was able to play in this ball game? He's obviously an impact-level player. Ability to Yeah, there's some versatile players. He's another one, ability to get to the rim with his athleticism, but he has that three-point threat. He's been very, very impressive, and boy, it would have been nice to see what he was capable of for the full game without that foul trouble. Here he is again.
Powell pushes it home. Huge impact on that man, Powell. And you also wonder, like, as at the other end, we have an offensive foul called on Newbury 100% as he goes straight down the line, and a great defensive stand from Adedo, who comes up hobbling a little bit. But you also wonder if, for Tarek Powell, what would have happened if he would have been subbed out on three fouls and just sat at that point for the rest of the half to then be able to start the second half.
Yeah.
But let's not diminish the impact that he's having so far for St. Charles in keeping them within touching distance of Haringey. 88-82, 5 minutes 27 left on the game clock.
Well, what a response there from St. Charles. They went down 9 points and they didn't look, they're confident from their body language. Nothing changed. They actually became more aggressive. Power with an easy steal and score, the 3. And now the offensive foul call. A little bit of a momentum shift there, and it cuts it down to a 6-point ball game. He's fouled out.
That was Newbury's 5th foul, the offensive foul. So that becomes even bigger he heads to the bench. But Newbury finishing with 24 points and 19 rebounds. So just the one short of that 2020 game. But that does take away what is a huge post presence for Haringey at both ends of the floor. Agu finds Smith. Agu up high, guarded by Adedu. Finds Smith in the corner for 3. No good. And how has Alex Dristis ended up with no one guarding him under the basket? Ademola at the other end goes up and under and answers with a nice finish underneath the basket. And again at the other end, Haringey answer back. And we are back to end-to-end basketball, folks. Powell pulls up in transition, a little bit short. Ball rattles around. Don't really know who's got it. Everyone, bodies all over the floor. And there's a jump ball called. And great to see either team picking up their opponent off the floor as well.
Well, we said it before, and no time like the present in terms of those 50-50 balls. You got to force the arrow to be the decision maker if you can. Get your hands on that ball and don't give up possession.
So it's a St. Charles timeout. Haringey lead 92-84. 4 minutes 33 left in the ball game. But Dwidu Newbury, having just fouled out, the 6'7 forward with 24 points and 19 rebounds. What sort of impact is that going to have on Haringey?
Well, obviously on the rebounding battles at both ends of the floor, he's going to be a presence that is now left. But he also he changes shots as well. So he's not got a lot of blocks. He's just in there and he's a presence and he's somebody that you have to be aware of the whole time. So it'll be interesting to see if St. Charles get any easier uncontested layups without him on the floor here.
And whilst we're waiting for the teams to retake the floor, just a reminder that we want to thank our sponsors for today's Sport England, Wilson Dynamic, SportServe, FIBA, AOC Sport, and of course Basketball England as the delivery organisation of the event. We have 3 great finals on the bill for today. The ABL final is looking like it's going to go down to the wire, and then they'll be followed by the WEABL at 3:15 and then EABL at 5:30. So make sure you check out the relevant YouTube pages for those games. St. Charles coming out with the aggressive run and jump. Full court press, but Haringey doing a relatively good job of weathering that storm. Young with the ball now. Finds Vella, who's going to drive baseline. Goes, what a take! Andreas Vella, a 6-foot guard, finishing at the rim as if he was much, much bigger.
Oh, it's funny there. He was almost surprised that the lane opened up, but he did take it.
And a foul has been called on Owen Young. I thought that was a relatively clean block, but we're up here at the top of the bleachers, so I'm not sure, but Franco Jardil is going to go to the free throw line. Well, three free throws, and Young just making sure he walks relatively close behind him. You can see the Haringey crowd not happy about that. A couple of the players just having a word with the referee.
10-point game.
And Young heads over to speak to the ref about why. He gives him a high five. To say, oh, mate, all right, you made the call. And Jardil is going to be at the line to shoot free.
Ooh.
Can't make the first.
Big, big three shot here.
Jardil on 0 points in 14 minutes so far for St. Charles. First trip to the free throw line. And long on the second as well.
Still a lot of time left in this one. 10-point ball game, 4 minutes to go. And the way the teams have gone on runs.
You can't rule anything out. Jardil makes the third, trims it to single digits. Well, that could have been a huge possession if he would have made all three at the line, but it's not always the way it goes. Distress inside Vella. Vella pulls up. Nice floater inside.
That's a great job. Great job there from Haringey, staying composed, sharing the basketball, eventually finding the open teammate right under the rim.
And here's Vella again with the deflection. And this young man's come into the game and made a couple of big time plays for Haringey. Had the tough finish on the right hand at the basket, and then that floater in the paint.
Well, this is the composure factor we talked about here. So we're coming into the last couple minutes of the ball game. You can see St. Charles trying to chase the game a little bit, put on a press, try and turn Haringey over. Can Haringey stay composed enough to really value the basketball and not give St. Charles the opportunity to make a little run here?
Powell inside, throws the head fake. Can't get the finish, rebounded by Agu. Recognizes he's going 1-on-4, pulls it back out, although he's trapped in the corner. Finds Young. Young to Dristus. And St. Charles are running and jumping everything at the moment. Haringey just playing keep ball around the perimeter. Young finds Dristus.
Good possession there. Haringey really being smart and intelligent, running the clock down, keeping possession of the ball, forcing St. Charles to scramble and then earn the right to the free throw line after a reaching foul.
And that foul on Akinbaye, he's going to send Vella to the line. Has an opportunity to extend the lead to 13. Short on the first. Looked quite low out of his hand. And the St. Charles crowd making some noise over on the far side. Vella misses them both, rebounded by Powell.
Rebound pick up from St. Charles, number 12. Drives.
Powell finds Ademola. Out to Akinbaye. No good.
They needed that to go.
3 minutes now remaining in the game. Haringey's lead at 11. Ball in the hands of Distress. Finds Agu. Agu barrels inside, tries to find Smith on the backdoor cut, but can't. Adedo finds Ademola. And what a defensive possession by Vella and Young to get back and contest that shot. Distress inside for two. And Haringey's lead now out to 13 as Ademola goes at the other end.
Oh, foul.
And Smith gets called for the foul, but you would say now that at 13 points, Haringey might have one hand on the ABL Championship. However, we did see in the semifinals, Haringey actually came back from 13 down when they were trailing to Stoke-on-Trent with 2 minutes to play and one on a three at the buzzer. So are they going to get a taste of their own medicine in this one, or are they going to hold on and keep St. Charles at bay? You've got a timeout, and you can look there at head coach Patrick Vauclia just talking over with his team his strategy for the next 2 minutes 26. And it's probably going to be a case of trying to attack the basket as much as they can do. And their transition game, which they've used to really good effect so far, they're going to have to really ramp that up now and try and get stops and easy, quick scores to trim this lead as much as they can do.
Well, what Haringey want to make sure that they do is that obviously they're trying not to lose this lead, but they've still got to play to win. If you become hesitant, and obviously they're thinking time and score situations, but they've still got to be in some way, shape or form aggressive. And the way that they've been moving the ball in the half court as they're trying to waste clock and manage to share it, and then eventually towards the end of the shot clock find an open teammate, they've got to continue to do that. They can't afford empty possession. So as much as they'll try and protect this lead here in this last 2.5 minutes, they still have to be aggressive in some way.
Both teams head out of the huddle. Haringey and St. Charles, both coaches having one timeout left apiece. Adamola is going to be at the line to two. And these are big free throws right here for Michael Adamola.
Adamola.
Long on the first.
Doesn't sit.
And short on the second, and it's cleaned up by Agu. Big rebound. Agu takes him to 25 rebounds for Franklin Agu. I hesitated there because I didn't think I'd read it right. 25 rebounds.
Unbelievable.
Go along with 21 points. And Adamola, though, in the meantime, comes up with a steal. Tries to go down the other end. Lane's cut off by Young. Powell, nowhere to go. And turns it, doesn't turn it over. Sorry, one referee pointing one way, the other pointing the other. Confused me for a second there. They're just going to confer and talk this one over. And it is going to be a Haringey ball. So it's deemed that it last came off the player in a black jersey. And so Haringey have possession. Distress. Young now finds Agu. 1 minute 50 left in the game. Agu driving straight down the lane with the Euro step. Gets the friendly roll on the right hand side. And we got a sub called. No timeout. Both teams started to head to the bench, but Franco Jardil is going to check into the game for St. Charles, who now trail by 15. You have to think that this is all Haringey from here on out, who have done a phenomenal job. That's a kick ball, and that will be a Haringey ball. They've done a really good job, in my opinion, of ramping up their defense, but also converting at the other end. St. Charles's offense has just been smothered a little bit. And Abiden Adedu also been much quieter. Back court called, yep. So that'll be a St. Charles ball. But Haringey have done a really good job of quieting Adedu and just taking away those driving lanes for him, making it much more difficult for him to score in and around the paint.
Yeah. They did a good job of shrinking the floor and taking away those driving lanes. I'm actually very impressed the way they're closing out this game as well.
Adedo for three, no good. Rebounded again by Franklin Agu. Distress ahead to Young, and Young's fouled, so that's going to send him to the free throw line. I can't talk highly enough of this man, Owen Young, either. He's been absolutely tremendous off the bench for Haringey. 21 points personal.
They're starting to feel it now, the Haringey fans. The coach turning around there, clapping at the fans with a massive smile. They've definitely got one hand on that championship trophy. Looking to make two hands with 1:24 remaining.
Young at the line, takes him to 22 points personal. And Haringey's lead up to 17, the largest of the game. And Haringey going to take their final timeout, leading by 17 with 1 minute 24 to go, just to set up their defense for this last 1 minute 24.
Oh, what a final. What to set the tone for today. What a great game of basketball we've had in this first ABL final. Very, very, very impressive performance from individuals and from both teams. It's been a great show of the talent here and in the ABL.
And if you have enjoyed watching and joining us for this game, don't forget we have two more coming up later with the WABL and EABL games. WABL coming up straight up after this at 3:15 as City of London Academy take on Charnwood College. And then at 5:30 p.m. Charnwood College men's team take on Barking Abbey School. Barking Abbey, by the way, heading for a three-peat, looking for their third championship in a row. Charnwood having previously won one championship, looking for their second. Both of those games promised to be absolutely tremendous games. But we have the small matter of the action remaining in the last 1 minute and 24 seconds here at the University of Essex. In what is a phenomenal arena as well. A brand new sports arena that the University of Essex have put up. And only really the second or third time that I've been down here, but a great facility and great to host the finals today. Haringey come up with a stop. And there's a couple of guys we've seen on the floor now that have yet to have been on the floor. So great to see them getting some action as well. Ivan Solis, one of those who had the ball stripped away there, but Haringey will keep possession.
Well, also make sure that you stay on the stream right after the game as the presentations take place, and there's obviously the debate on who is the most valuable player.
Yeah, so we're on the spirit of a debate. Where would yours go?
Well, I mean, there's been some tremendous performances throughout the Haringey roster, but boy, oh boy. Sorry, I almost called in Obi there. Franklin Agu, what a performance from that young man. Played, I don't think he's been out the ball game at all.
No, 38 minutes, 49 seconds.
Played every second of this game. Is currently, with a minute remaining, 23 points, 9 for 22 from the field, and a whopping 26 rebounds. 20 defensive, 6 offensive. He has been a monster in this ball game. However, in terms of the debate, Mr. Newbury, 24 points, 19 rebounds, 10 offensive. He's had more offensive rebounds than he has defensive. And you look down there, both their plus minuses are great and their indexes just 3 apart. I mean, it's tough to call it. But Obi has been out there the whole ball game. So, I said Obi. Sorry. Franklin Agu has been out there the whole time. Two great performances there. Stay tuned to find out who will be the winner of that MVP award. They do look the same as well, to be fair. Play the same way. Great. I'm sure Obi taught him everything he knows.
So Haringey at the line to shoot two. The lead now at their biggest that it's been all game. Now it's just a case of wrapping it up as Adedu comes up with the rebound for St. Charles. And we can't talk about the two big performers for Haringey without talking about Abiden Adedu, who's been absolutely great for St. Charles at the other end. Adedu finishing with 31 points and 17 rebounds. He had that huge first half, but Haringey really zoned in on him in the second half and have limited him.
Yeah, an incredible performance from that young man. He should be definitely proud. I know he'll be upset that they didn't get the championship win, but 31 points, a massive 10 for 10 from the free throw line, 100%, 17 rebounds, an index of 42, an incredible stat line for him.
Corner free for Small. No good, and it's hit out of bounds.
And one thing that does, something that has gone under the radar is the fouls drawn by these players as well. They've all done a great job of drawing fouls. I mean, Agu drawn 8 fouls, Newbury drawn 7 fouls. Like it's a talent in order for a player to
have the smarts and the ability to get to the free throw line. I think that does go under the radar sometimes.
So Young with the ball and he's immediately fouled. 39 seconds left to go. Young's going to have the chance to go to the free throw line to add another couple points to his personal total. And the Haringey crowd look like they've come down to the bottom end of the bleachers as if they're ready to ready to storm the floor at the end of the game.
They are primed and ready. They're almost in the starting blocks of an athletics meet.
Both teams fouling at either end, just delaying their opportunity to have the chance to celebrate with the team. Young makes them both at the line. St. Charles have it in the hands of Small. Small penetrates. Adedu guarded really closely by Agu. Backing by, kicks to the corner for three. No good. Rebounded by Adedu, goes up, gets the and one. So basket's going to count. Fouls on Cameron Morris for Haringey. Adedu heads to the line for one.
Well, it's been a great final here in the ABL, and credit to the two coaches and these two teams. They've really brought it and had a great battle today. And Haringey look like they're going to take this one, but credit to both teams. St. Charles, they're still trying. 21 seconds to go. They haven't given up. Not letting them dribble it out. Still trying to get the scores and steals. And great spirit from them.
Less than a possession remaining on the clock. 21.3 seconds. Akinbaye kicks out. Small throws up the free. No good. Rebounded by Agu. And that could be a big rebound for him. And a foul called. And at this point, surely you just let it go. But that could be a big rebound for Franklin Agu, because a lot of the times these MVP awards, when it's so close, it does come down to that index and their efficiency in the game. And that one rebound could have a big impact.
Well, you can feel it now. The bench has risen up for Haringey. Coach going down, giving his team some high fives. The Haringey fans looking like they're ready to celebrate this one. And they will, in fact, remain undefeated for the season. An incredible achievement.
Akinbaye pulls up with three. No good. Rebounded by Vella. Vella kicks out. Comes up in the hands of Small. And there we go. The crowd rush the floor to celebrate with Haringey, who take the 2018-2019 ABL Championship. And what great scenes to finish the game as the Basketball England staff struggle to get the awards onto the court. But that's phenomenal for Haringey to see them celebrate in that way, and a fully deserved performance for them as well.
Yeah, always as a coach, it's these moments that really put a smile on your face, seeing how much it means to these young players, and they gave everything they got. There's been some tremendous performances, but what an achievement to go 16-0 in the regular season, and then obviously undefeated in the knockout stages here of the playoffs, all three wins. So a whopping 19-0 season for Haringey. A tremendous job from all those players. Credit to Frank Batimba and the coaching job and the staff that he has around him. What a ball game.
So while we just catch our breath ever so slightly at the end of what was an end-to-end game, I don't know how the players must be feeling.
What a nice touch here from St. Charles. The fans have come down to give their last remaining team shout. Really, really nice touch there.
So we're just going to allow the Basketball England staff chance to set up the awards and clear the court, take everyone away from the floor for the celebrations. And then we will bring you the presentation ceremony of obviously the runners-up medals for St. Charles and then the winners' medals for Haringey, along with that sought-after MVP award. Now, we've talked about it a little bit towards the end of the game. Who do we think that MVP award is going to go to?
Well, could go to either of the guys, but I'm going to put my money on Agu. He's been the big-time performer, played the whole 40 minutes. It's just that whopping 27 rebounds. I mean, boy, you talk about ways to impact winning. That definitely is one.
Got to add to that 6 assists as well.
Oh.
Played the full 40, whereas Dwido Newbury came up with 24 points, 19 rebounds, 3 assists, and 2 blocks. I mean, you can barely separate their 2 stat lines. But I agree. Franklin Agu, for me, was probably the standout performer. So just a slight pause here while the Basketball England staff look to be conferring around who's going to take the MVP award. And a reminder as well, if you are still with us whilst we wait for the award ceremony, we have 2 more games coming up. So as if that game wasn't enough, we have 2 more games of action to come up. The WEABL finals between City of London Academy and Charnwood College at 3:15 over on the WEABL YouTube page. And then on the EABL YouTube page, Charnwood College, who will take on Barking Abbey School at 5:30 p.m.
One by one, I want you to all give a massive round of applause to your respect for the effort that they put in.
And then you see shots there on your screen of the St. Charles team, obviously down and dejected, but you can't take away from the season that they've had as a team. Obviously finishing top of their league at 15-3, winning the league on a points difference. But then also their route to the final with big wins against COH, ENL, and also against Aston Manor by 1 in the semi-final. So they come up now to receive from the relevant dignitaries their runners-up medals for the game.
Yeah, you can see there's a lot of proud parents and family and friends in the crowd there showing their appreciation for all the efforts that they've made throughout the season. And as much as it hurts in these moments, like we said at the start of the game, a lot of these guys will be returning next year, a lot of 2020 graduates. So that taste and that bitter feeling of a loss, that can really motivate you for the next year. And I'm sure they have a great shot at returning to the final next year. And maybe we will see them again, and maybe they will come out on top in that one. But today, it is Haringey's day.
St. Charles will return 7 of their team to next year, as you say. But on the flip side, Haringey are going to return 9. So we could be sat here in a year's time with these 2 teams in front of us again. And I mean, that's a game that I will sign up for right now, because I would love to see another 40 minutes of basketball between these 2 teams. We've been really treated to a great final for me today.
Yeah.
And now we see Haringey coming up and receiving the winners' medals.
The X Factor performers, who actually, we're talking about 2 guys. Let's not write out Mr. Young. 26 points and 6 for 9 from the 3-point line. Coming off the bench, 7 rebounds, 4 assists, an index of 28. Boy, what a performance from him.
And the thing that those stats don't show for me is some of those frees, some of those buckets were really timely and needed at crucial times. And you never get that from a stat sheet.
Yeah.
But actually, he stepped up when it mattered most and made some huge shots. The and one for the 3-pointer being one of those moments.
Yeah, that's a great point. Just as St. Charles seemed to get in striking distance, he managed to make the play which kept them at bay and continued to extend their lead. That's a great point. Timely plays from him. But here we go, the moment of truth.
Well, So both teams just going through the customary handshakes at the end of the game.
So before I make an announcement on the MVP, I just want to say a massive thank you to the coaches, to the players, and
the MC in the arena just wrapping up and thanking everyone for coming out and supporting today, as well as the coaching staff, the referees, the table officials, and the volunteers who have helped make the ABL final possible today.
Hashtag ABL and hashtag together we basketball, is it? Together we basketball. Okay, so.
And now, the coveted MVP award
goes to. Come have a drum roll, please. Franklin Agoo!
And it is. It's Franklin Agoo who takes the MVP award. And rightly so.
Yeah.
Stat line for him of 23 points, 27 rebounds, 6 assists. A huge performance in all 40 minutes for the young man who led his team to that championship.
Well, congratulations to Haringey. Congratulations to Franklin Agoo. Shout out to Obi if you're watching. What a performance from that young man. What a performance from multiple players on the team. What a performance from the team.
And so on behalf of everybody here at the University of Essex and the ABL, myself, Liam Jefferson, my co-commentator, Mark Jarrin, we want to thank you for joining us on this YouTube live stream. Remember, two more games coming up over on the WEABL and EABL live stream. So make sure you check out those two games as well. But for now, thank you for joining us and goodbye.
So I'd like to welcome the City of London!